Kashmir remains under curfew. Two people, including a woman, were killed as security forces fired at a mob in South Kashmir's Kazigund. Separatists have issued a four-day protest program. CM Mehbooba Mufti's close aide and former deputy CM Muzaffar Baig has made a startling disclosure. He told India Today's Rajdeep Sardesai that the chief minister was kept in the dark over the operation to eliminate Burhan Wani. Amid the continuing violence, many Kashmiri pandit families have begun to migrate to Jammu, the centre said, towards the pandit cause. For his constituency. After blunders in Punjab, Delhi Chief Minister Arvind Kejriwal went into damage control mode. The Aam Admi Party chief washed utensils at the Golden Temple, performed seva. A college student who was gang raped 3 years ago by five men in the Rohtak district has allegedly been raped again by the same men. RBI Governor Raghuram Rajan has said that the country needs to continue fine-tuning rules on collateral and interest rates to ensure financial institutions have enough incentives to keep lending to the poor. Thousands of locals in Gujarat's Nadiad were evacuated after a chlorine gas leak was detected from a plant owned by the government. Heavy downpour has crippled life in Guwahati, forcing people to look for safer areas. The rain has also swelled the Brahmaputra River that flows into Bangladesh. Roads remain submerged in Haridwar district of Uttarakhand after several days of a heavy downpour. Authorities in Ghaziabad successfully rescued a cow that had been stuck in a sewer. The cow was trapped in sludge after it fell from a ramp into the 8 feet deep gutter. In an encounter between security forces and Maoists at Dumrinala forest on the border of Aurangabad and Gaya districts of Bihar, 8 security personnel and 3 terrorists have been killed. After a Dalit family was assaulted for allegedly skinning a dead cow in Gujarat's Gir, protests have turned violent, leading to tension in parts of the state. A group of youth locked in an ugly fight inside a college hostel in Uttar Pradesh's Varanasi have been caught on camera. The footage shows the groups of students clashing with each other. In Ghaziabad, the bride went missing moments after she got married. The couple from Haryana were facing stiff opposition from the girl's family. An Iraqi woman who went to a hospital in Gurgaon for treatment was allegedly molested by a hospital staffer. She alleged that she was harassed by an unknown person while undergoing treatment. Finance Minister Arun Jaitley has missed his scheduled visit to China. He was supposed to meet with the Economic Affairs Secretary Shaktikant Das. On the occasion of Bank Nationalization Day, a human chain will be organized by the All India Banks Employees Association with the support of trade unions and political parties to oppose the banking policies of the Modi government. The Bombay High Court will be hearing a PIL seeking a stay on the Goa government's new law that seeks to regularize unauthorized structures constructed before February last year. In the midst of turmoil in Turkey, the second batch of a group of Indian school students stuck in the country will return today. The group of over 100 were in the country for an athletics meet. Terming it as a deliberate attack on the Ambedkarite movement, the demolition of Ambedkar Bhavan at Dadar, Baba Saheb Ambedkar's grandson Prakash Ambedkar will be leading a rally to protest against the move. The National Green Tribunal has directed the Delhi government to deregister all diesel vehicles that are more than 10 years old with immediate effect in the National Capital Region. More trouble for AAP as one of the party's MLAs has been charged by his wife of abusing her. The Aam Aadmi Party MLA from Kondli, Manoj Kumar, appeared before the Delhi Commission for Women. Two brutal murders in Outer Delhi have raised doubts on the law and order situation yet again. In Puthkalan, a youth was shot dead, while in Mangolpuri, assailants barged into the house of an elderly man and killed him. Heavy rain on Monday morning led to heavy waterlogging and traffic jams across the national capital. Large parts of the city were inundated and office goers had a tough time. With several parts of the city experiencing waterlogging, Deputy Chief Minister of Delhi, Manish Sisodia, held a high-level meeting to review the situation and directed all agencies to conduct joint inspections and submit their reports. The Maharashtra Anti-Terror Squad has told the Bombay High Court that its preliminary inquiry has found that there was no exchange of calls between former State Minister Eknath Khadse and terrorist Dawood Ibrahim, and that no link could be established between the two. The monsoon session of the Maharashtra legislature commenced amid vociferous protests by the opposition against the Fadnavis government on issues like corruption, the Ahmednagar gang rape case and the agrarian crisis in the state. Tensions prevailed in Ahmednagar, where a teen girl was brutally raped by three men who broke her limbs before killing her. Locals demanded justice and have called for a shutdown. The Bombay High Court began its cross-examination of Jaydev Thackeray, the estranged son of the late Shiv Sena chief Bal Thackeray, in the ongoing dispute over Bal Thackeray's will. Jaydev had filed a suit in the High Court challenging the validity of his father's will. The NIA has filed its charge sheet before a special court in the case where a youth from Malwani was being recruited for fighting for the Islamic State in Iraq and Syria. A scuffle broke out between two groups of students in the University of Hyderabad campus after a meeting was held to show solidarity on the Kashmir situation. The meeting was organized by a group of students and teachers, and this led to a clash. AIMIN chief Asaduddin Owaisi has reiterated that the court would provide, that his party would provide legal aid to the ISIS terror suspects arrested by the NIA. He was speaking at an anti-ISIS gathering in Mehboobnagar. The first building of Andhra Pradesh's new secretariat complex in Amravati will be completed by the end of this month, and efforts are on to develop the entire complex by 2018. A man died after a mob beat him and his friend after accusing them of killing a 19-year-old girl in Guntur. Police say this duo had barged into the house of the victim, who was alone at home, and assaulted her. The Hyderabad High Court has said that a road rage victim can claim compensation from any party involved in the accident. The court observed that the authorities have no right to question the action on the part of the victims. After being accused of aiding the suicide of a senior police officer, Minister K.J. George has quit the government. K.J. George had resisted demands for his resignation, claiming that there was no direct evidence against him. George's resignation came hours after a local court in Karnataka ordered an FIR against him and two other police officers. The chief minister of the state has accepted his resignation. The opposition BJP marched from the Karnataka Assembly to the state governor's house and submitted a memorandum requesting for the suicide case of MK Ganpati to be handed over to the CBI. The police have booked 912 motorists in a span of mere 5 hours in the city for drunk driving. Officials tested over 10,000 drivers. Between them and 912 offenders were booked. The Bangalore Water Supply and Sewerage Board owes a private power firm 150 crore rupees. This massive debt due to the digging of bore wells in the city. The water regulator says it can't pay the debt in one go. The custody of Ram Kumar, who has been accused of murdering techie Swati, has been extended by 15 days till the 1st of August. The Tamil Nadu government has appealed against the acquittal of Kanchi Shankaracharya in the Shankar Raman murder case. The High Court has given 2 weeks' time to the Shankaracharya to file his reply. A gangster in Madurai was hacked to death. He was attacked by a gang of three men who smashed in his face with bricks. The murder took place at a crowded spot. Kerala is planning to launch an insurance scheme for more than 25 lakh migrant labourers in the state. The Chief Minister Pinarayi Vijayan said that this would also serve as a database, noting that the number of crimes involving migrants were on the rise. In the wake of increasing cases of diphtheria in the state, Health Minister K.K. Shailaja has promised a new health policy by creating an e-health register. The Transport Commissioner has issued notice to the ICE officers to stick to blue beacons on their cars and not to use blue flags on their official vehicles. The state BJP president has approached the High Court challenging its decision to appoint a senior advocate as CM Pinaray Vijayan's legal advisor. The BJP chief claims that the appointment had violated Bar Council rules. The Kerala Assembly has passed a resolution against the SBT-SBI merger amidst opposition from MLA O. Rajagopal. Veteran author and Magsaysay Award winner Mahashweta Devi has been hospitalized since a month. She's being treated for acute chest pain and breathing problems. TMC leader Mukul Roy has launched a scathing attack on the Congress. He says that after the drubbing in the recently concluded state elections, many senior Congress leaders were keen to join the TMC. A bus conductor pushed a minor from a moving bus, leading to critical injuries. The conductor is absconding and the student's condition is serious. After a tip-off, the police in Burdwan conducted raids and recovered 123 live bombs from a house. The police have also detained 10 people in connection with the seizure. In West Bengal's Burdwan, a monkey caused terror among locals. Several women and children have been attacked. Former Turkish Air Force chief has been arrested on suspicion of playing a role in the failed military coup in the country. The Turkish media has claimed that the former military general may be involved in the failed coup attempt. Turkish soldiers who fled to neighboring Greece in a military chopper after the weekend coup appeared in court to respond to charges brought in against them by a Greek prosecutor. Kazakhstan's president has called the deadly shootout in Almaty an act of terrorism. One gunman, who is believed to be a follower of an ultra-conservative school of Islam, was behind three deadly shootouts. Naval commanders from China and the US met and talked for the first time face-to-face since the July 12 arbitrating tribunal decision on the South China Sea. The city of Nice released drone footage showing the crowd of thousands of people who turned out for a memorial service to honor victims of the truck attack. The French Prime Minister was booed by a crowd gathered in Nice for a memorial service to honor victims of the truck attack. Videos on the internet showed the devastating aftermath of heavy airstrikes in rebel-held Aleppo. Two suicide bombers tried to ram vehicles laden with explosives through two Yemeni military checkpoints, killing 10 people. Indonesia began revaccinating dozens of children that received fake important medication from a drug-making ring busted last month after operating for more than a decade. 9 people were buried in an avalanche in southwest China's Tibet. They were confirmed dead. Passionate whistlers gathered at a concert hall in Japan to compete in the World Whistlers Convention. A census of the Queen's swans has taken place. It takes place annually on the Thames River for the last 800 years. On Monday, a group of boats led by the Queen's swan marker continued the tradition. An unmanned SpaceX rocket blasted off from Florida on Monday to send a cargo ship to the International Space Station. Protesters marched on the streets of Durban, where the 2016 International AIDS Conference is being held. Renowned American photographer Spencer Tunick has turned his clothes-dropping lens to Colombia in a novel initiative aimed at promoting unity between rival factions in the civil war that has gripped the country. The Supreme Court has directed the BCCI to implement a majority of the Lodha panel recommendations. The Apex Court also implemented the age cap to end the reign of officials like Sharad Pawar and N. Srinivasan. But there was relief on one count. The Supreme Court did not force the board to implement the no ad break recommendation between matches. BCCI President Anurag Thakur has revealed that the board will pick the batting, bowling and fielding coaches in September. Kareena Kapoor Khan, who's expecting her first baby, lashed out at the media when asked about her professional future. She said that she is only pregnant, not a corpse. Desi girl Priyanka Chopra has turned 34. The actor celebrated her birthday in New York. Known as the effortlessly stylish Khan, Fawad Khan will be opening the couture week for designer Manish Malhotra. The trailer of Ekta Kapoor's next production, A Flying Jutt, has been released. Talented newcomer Tiger Shroff will be seen playing a superhero. The shooting for the sequel of Jolly LLB has begun. In its second installment, the movie will see Akshay Kumar and Anu Kapoor play lawyers who are at loggerheads. Pico actress Deepika Padukone shared the first teaser of her upcoming Hollywood debut, Triple X, Return of Xander Cage. The 10-second clip lays the base for the final trailer that will be launched on the 20th of July. Katie Holmes was recently spotted in New York with another man soon after reports of her split with Jamie Foxx. Actor Jennifer Lawrence, who despite not featuring in the movie Star Trek Beyond, is being called the real inspiration behind Star Trek character Jayla. The makers of the film kept Lawrence in mind as their muse. Pop star Kylie Minogue seems to be in the mood to start a family of her own with fiancé Joshua Sasson. Mariah Carey is quite a doting mom, according to the reports in several tabloids. The company that has taken over Nokia says that it is expected to launch the new phones by the end of this year. The buzz is that there are two more Nokia phones on the anvil. In a bid to boost adoption of Windows 10, Microsoft is giving away a free Dell Inspiron 15 laptop if it can't upgrade your existing laptop to the latest Windows operating system. As per reports, Google has shut down an internal project to build a high-end standalone virtual reality headset to directly take on Facebook's Oculus Rift and HTC's Vive. In its largest ever deal, Japan's SoftBank Group has agreed to buy ARM Holdings for $31 billion. ARM Holdings is the most valuable tech company listed in London. A Chinese consortium has bought the Opera internet browser for $600 million. The Opera developers have confirmed the move that was sealed after a public share offer.